Good afternoon. I want to welcome everyone to this session of my video. I want to appreciate everyone that's been following my video right from the first video to this time. The previous video I spoke concerning the interaction between explosive and rock during blasting, but today I'll be talking on power factor, or what is known as a specific charge. So here I have some things. Just make some drops on what is powder factor, importance of powder factor on blasting, then the formulas, formula breakdown for powder factor, how to calculate powder factor for one explosive, two or more explosive in case, some cases whereby they decide to use high explosive and low explosive in the place of dynamite and alcohol. So the powder factor, how to work on the powder, the formula to calculate powder factor. So powder factor is defined as the amount or the quantity of explosive that is required to fragment or maybe a tonnage or 1 cubic meter of a rock. What I mean is that the quantity of explosive that is loaded into a charge length of a hole to fragment a specific volume of rock, that is the quantity of explosive used to disintegrate 1 centimeter cube of rock. So that's power factor in a simple way. So it's the amount of explosive that is charged into a known length of a hole to fragment a specific 1 cubic meter of a rock. So, powder factor is very, very important in the assessment of blasting, because it takes charge of the economic aspect of the blasting. What I mean by economic aspect is that blasting from review covers about 0.2% of total cost of mine operation when it comes to solid mineral or mining activities that involve drilling and blasting. So it's very important that we will ensure that the blasting operation is carried out at a level whereby the economic stability of the project is not being challenged by blasting operation. So it's the aspect of blasting is being quantified in the aspect of economy using powder factor. So it's powder factor that determines the quantity of explosive that will be used to fragment the oil in question. So and as we all know, the aim of mining is to ensure that there's profit. So if the mine operation is not profitable, then the so-called mining or the so-called mineral is not to be called at all, and it doesn't worth mining if there is nothing to write home about the economic aspect. So the power factor of a blast is as important as the safety of the mine. So it's very important. Powder factor is said to vary with the strength of the rock. So we have powder factor and we have rock strength. So as the rock strength increases, the powder factor also increases. So rocks that are of soft strength tends to require less of quantity of explosive to fragment them. So the powder factor varies with the strength of the rock. That means rocks like granite require more of explosive to detonate, to blast them, compared to rock like shale, every other softer rocks compared to that. So the powder factor of the blast varies but the strength of the ore or the industrial mineral to be blasted. So having mentioned that, so I'll move directly to the importance of powder factor. Powder factor is used to as I've said earlier, is used to know the economic of the blasting, the economic status of the blasting. So maybe the blasting is that which is consuming money compared to what has been budgeted. So what makes that a factor to be very important is also that if the quantity of explosive being used, the blast is too much, then there's probability of having some environmental challenges in the place of fly, in the place of ground vibration, meaning the explosive energy being released at the detonation is greater than the energy required to perform the work, which is the fragmentation activities. So in the case of excess energy, the excess energy tends to perform unwanted operation, which can be the projection of rock into the environment, the vibration of the ground, and ear blasts in the place of noise. So powder factor is used to control some of these environmental hazard of blasting. So what I'm trying to say, powder factor is of importance to maintain the safety of the blast size, and also to quantify in the place of the economic status of the blast. So those are some of the importance of the powder factor. So the formula used in calculating powder factor is the weight of explosive all over the volume or tonnage of the rock. So powder factor is the ratio of the weight, that is the quantity of explosive used for blast, then divided by volume or the tonnage of the whole output from the blast. So it's far beyond this, but I would like to start the breakdown from how we get a volume of the rock. The volume of the rock. The volume of the rock is the volume of the rock is gotten from the product of the body times the spacing. The volume of the rock that will be fragmented. How do I come about this? This is a bench. This is a bench. This is a drill hole. This is a drill hole. So I'm tend to project the bench. So the drill hole, the drill hole, the drill hole, the drill hole. So for this hole tends to vary like this. So single is thanks to have a variation like this, like you have a body and you have a spacing. So the volume of the rock is the product of the body, the spacing, and the depth of the depth. So we tend to get the volume of the rock being fragmented by one. So after getting the volume is body times spacing times the bench height. But in case of maybe a tonnage, volume times spacing times bench height times the specific gravity of the rock. So this how we get the volume or the tonnage of the material to be fragmented. Then how do we get the weight? The weight. Or the weight or the mass of the explosive. So as I said earlier, powder factor is the mass, let's say in kg of explosive all over the tonnage of rock. So how do we get a mass of the explosive? From density of the explosive equals to the volume all over the mass of explosive, the volume of explosive. So the volume of explosive in this case is the same thing as the volume of the hole, the hole being charged. So as we all know, this is the charge coulomb. Charge coulomb. Then this is the standing coulomb. Then this is the whole length. So the charge, the volume of the explosive used is the volume of the material that is occupying this specific volume of O, this aspect. So we tend to get the volume of the explosive as using the volume of the O pi d squared over 4 multiplied by the charge, the coulomb, the charge coulomb. So this is the simple way of getting the volume, the charge coulomb, that is the coulomb is the length, is the coulomb length of the hole that is being filled, that is. So as I said, the section of the hole is divided. So if the rock is not of layer rock, where the subdrill. So the coulomb length, in case if the subdrill will be the total bench height plus subdrill minus the stemming length. So that we'll get the length of the hole being filled with the explosive, then we'll get the volume of the explosive. After getting the volume of the explosive, the mass. So the mass of the explosive will be density of the explosive multiplied by the volume of the explosive. So this is the simple way of calculating a powder factor for a single explosive. In the case whereby it's the only one explosive that's being used for the blasting. So what you need to get is get the total length of the hole, measure the hole before charging, record. Then after charging, before stemming, measure the length of the hole again. Then subtract the initial from the natural. Then you from the original present after charging. Then you get the stemming length. Then from there you get charge coulomb. So after getting the charge coulomb, you multiply the charge coulomb by diameter of the hole multiplied by pi over 4. So that will give you the volume of the hole that is being filled, that is charged with explosives. So knowing the volume of the hole that is being charged with explosive, then you multiply that for the density of the explosive. How do we get the density of the explosive? Each explosive with a manual in the carton usually states the density of the explosive. So you can get the density of each explosive from the manufacturer manual. So you have that, then you multiply it with the volume, then you get the max of the explosive. So having get the mass of the explosive in the case of a single explosive, what you need to do is to get your powder factor straightforward, like the mass of the explosive all over the volume of rock, that is max of explosive all over volume times spacing times bench height. So that is that for a single, then for a single explosive. But in the case of whereby you use two or more explosives, like for example you have a drill hole whereby you desire to from here to here, you stem with high explosive, then from here to here you stem with low explosive in the case of arm 4, then in the place of let's see super power 90 explosive. So super power 90 explosive is low and high explosive of different density entirely. You have your stemming here, no subdrill. So in this case, what you need to do is to first calculate the the mass of the low explosive, the mass of the high explosive multiply, add the two together, then that will be the total mass. What am I trying to explain? Like, you have mass 1 plus mass 2. This will give you the total mass. So how do I get mass 1? What you need to do is to, after charging this, we know H, which is the total length. Then H, this one, H is L low explosive plus L high explosive plus stemming, which is T. So what we need to do now is, at initial, you charge this, you know the total length, you charge this, after charging this, you measure the O. Then let's say, for example, H is 6 meter, for example, or no, let's say 15 meter, that's 3 rod, 15 meter, that's 5 rods. Then you charge the first charge, you charge in, you measure again. Then your little measurement is like is 8, so you decide to 8 meter. Then after that, maybe you stem or you don't stem, you charge the next explosive, the low explosive, maybe that is just 5. For example, I'm giving example, then later we'll do a design. Let's say that is 3 meter, then you're stemming. Meaning 4, that is 4 meters. So like this, you have the length of each charge. The first column here to here is 8 meter, then here to here is 3 meter, then here to here is 4 meter. So you have this, and you have the whole, you know, the whole diameter. So with this, you have the charge, the column charge, the column charge length for each of the explosive. So you have for explosive 1, you have for explosive 2 before the stemming. So what you need to do is to calculate the volume for each of the charge length. So what you need to do next is calculate the volume for each of the charge lengths. V for I explosive will be 5d squared over 4 multiplied by the length of the charge, which is 8. Then you have for V low explosive, that will be 5d squared over 4 multiplied by 3. So this is a simple way, and in most cases there's some challenges in this case. In most cases, you may have the explosive, the high explosive, in case if it is not bulk, or if it is not bulk explosive, or all the slurry explosive, whereby you use cartridge, then in most cases you may likely have to make use of some factors. What I'm trying to say is that in most cases whereby the explosive is not of the same diameter, that is decoupled, then you have to make use of some factors to cater for the decoupled space. So, you know, after stemming, during stemming, there's probability of compressibility, that the O get compressed. So you have to consider that. But in this case, I'm assuming there is no compressibility and there's no shrinkage. So after that, after calculating the volume of the high explosive, you get the volume of the high explosive, VHE, you get the volume of the low explosive, VLE. So what you need to do is to, you know, the density of the high explosive, you know the density of the low explosive from the manufacturer manual. So after having the volume of the high explosive, the volume of this O that is containing the high explosive, then the volume of this O that is containing the low explosive, you have the density of the high explosive from the manufacturer, then you have the density of the low explosive. Let's say for ampoule, the density is 800, then maybe for this, in the case of superpower 91128. So you have the two, you have this, you calculate this from your field measurement, during charging you take note, then from this also you get this from the manual. So having the two, so you get the mass of the I exclusive, which is the density of the I exclusive multiplied by the volume of the I exclusive. Then you have the mass of the low exclusive plus the density of the low exclusive multiplied by the volume exclusive. You have the two. You get two from this field. So you have the total mass of exclusive that is loaded into the hole. Into the hole. So that will be max of I exclusive plus max of low exclusive. So you have the total mass. So from there, you get total mass of exclusive that is going to load here. In most cases, whereby you still have an additional exclusive, maybe the booster or any other thing. So you need to cater for that, knowing the volume of the hole that's occupying the required exclusive. So having this, then you can from there get your power factor to be the total mass, which is M I exclusive plus M low exclusive all over the body times the spacing times the bench height times the specific gravity, as the case may be. So this is just for a single hole. So in the case whereby you have you have 100 holes and you are to calculate the quantity of explosive. Another important of powder factor is that it makes you it gives you the ability to project the quantity, the amount of explosive to transport from the magazine. So before you go into the magazine, as we know, that explosive is a very sensitive and dangerous material that must be kept sealed and prevent from hoodlums and terrorists. So it's a good point of material to be moved from magazine. So in the case you have 100 holes. So having get the volume of the explosive multiplied by density of the explosive, which gives you the mass of the explosive. All we need is to multiply the mass of the explosive times the number of holes. That means 100 multiplied by the mass of the explosive. So having know that, then you can from there go to your powder factor. Power factor will now be the max of the explosive multiplied by 100 all over body times spacing times bench height times number of holes then times the specific gravity. So in most cases, it's always good that we just use just for one hole, because by the time you start doing the volume multiplied by the density multiplied by number of holes, then volume times spacing times bench height times number of holes times specific gravity, number of holes, number of holes. So just use a single hole to get the powder factor. So that is that. So I'd like to conclude on this note that powder factor is one of the most important parameter in blast design that must be prepared well and be calculated well to avoid error in blasting and lower in the level of safety during blasting. So powder factor is beyond what an engineer can just oversight and decide to use whatsoever thing and he wants to achieve the results. It's not that the result will not be good, but some of the disadvantage if the powder factor is too low is that there will be high productivity of oversight, there will be environmental disasters and impact. So thank you very much. Like my page and follow. Thank you.